Hello students, welcome to our channel Learning Notebook. In today's video, we will do part 3 of chapter Geometry. In this part 3, we will learn about circle. Students, this is a circle. Some of the real life examples of a circle are donut, button, pizza and a coin. The middle point of a circle is called center of the circle, as shown in the figure. Students, a center is usually named by letter O. The line passing through the center is called diameter. So here, line AB is the diameter of the circle. Students, the diameter can be drawn as horizontal, vertical or slanting line, but it should pass through center of the circle. The diameter divides a circle into two equal parts. Each part is called semicircle. So in this figure, the diameter is dividing the circle into two semicircles. Similarly, a diameter drawn vertically divides the circle into two semicircles. In the same way, diameters drawn as slanting lines divide the circle into two semicircles. The length of circle is called its circumference. Students, we know how to measure the length of a line. So you must be curious to measure length of a circle. So let's do a small activity to find length of a circle. Take a round rubber band and cut it from any point. You may take your parents' help for this. Lay the cut rubber band flat on the table and measure it with a scale. This length is the length of a circle or its circumference. So here, the length of the rubber band or its circumference is 15 centimeter. Now, diameter equals to 2 into radius, where OB or OA is the radius of the circle. You can easily remember the relationship between radius and diameter from the table of 2. Here, numbers in the red are radius and numbers in yellow are diameter. So, if radius of a circle is 2, its diameter would be 4. Similarly, if radius of a circle is 4, its diameter would be 8. And if radius of a circle is 8, its diameter would be 16. So students, we can also say that radius is half of diameter. All the points on the circle are equidistant from the center. Equidistant means equal distance. So here, all the points on the circle A, B, C, D and E are equidistant from center O. Let's do an exercise based on what we have learned in this part. Question is, in the circle, name the following. Students, we are given with this circle and we have to find center of this circle, which is point O. Next, radius of this circle, which is OB and OP. Third is diameter. Students, we learned that the line passing through the center is the diameter of the circle. So here, BP is the diameter of the circle. Next, points in the interior of the circle are point O and point A. And in the end, points on the circle are point B, point C and point P. So students, in this video, we learned about circle, radius, diameter and circumference of the circle. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, then do hit the like button. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel Learning Notebook. and make sure to press the bell icon. Thank you. Bye-bye. See you in the next video.